Hello students, first of all I would like to welcome you all in this YouTube channel of Northeast Junior College. This is your political science class, and in my last class I discussed the partition of India in 1947. So regarding my last class, some students they were confused about two topics, that is communal rights and causes for migration. So now I'm discussing these two topics. First of all, I will draw the map of India, then discuss these topics. So students, this is the map of India, and I'm underlying the all the areas, important major areas. Now if we look at the map, we can see that this is India's map before independence. That means all these areas were part of Indian territory. Now here this area was divided into two parts, that is east and west. The west part was a part of, was included with Pakistan, and the East Punjab was part of India. Then again Bengal was partitioned, and one part, that is western part of Bengal, is with our India, and the eastern part of Bengal is with Pakistan, that is East Pakistan, and it is now present day Bangladesh. So, and this is the northwest frontier province. Now, during partition, what happened? These areas were the mainly the Muslim majority areas, and these areas were the mainly Hindu majority areas, and this was mainly Sikh majority areas. Now what happened? Now one student asked me about communal rights. Communal rights basically means when on the basis of religion one community of one community attacked the another community or killed people from another community on the basis of religion, we can call it communal riots. Means the people of different two communities, community A and community B, they are fighting over religion. This we can call as communal riots. In India, some areas like Lahore, then Kolkata, then Amritsar and Delhi, then Noakhali in Bangladesh, these areas were mainly affected by the communal riots during the time of partition. So due to communal riots, what happened? Many people were forced to shift their home from one place to another. Another thing, the term migration means shifting from one place to another. So during the time of partition, what happened? People from these areas, they shifted from here to there, and people from these areas, they shifted from here to there. So this process was called migration, and it happened because of one of the reason was communal riots. Then another reason was that in this process, many women were killed, many were kidnapped and raped, and many children were also killed. Many people lost their lives. Almost 80 lakh people. It is 80 lakh, not 40 lakh. So 80 lakh people migrated from one place to another. Means all over India, during the time of partition, 80 lakh people migrated. And in this process, many people have to live in the refugee camps. So after living for months in a refugee camp, people decided to shift from their homeland to the land where their religious people lived. So in this process, mainly this was mainly Muslim majority area, this was Sikh majority area, and this Hindu majority areas. Now what happened? Many minority people, suppose in this area, many Hindu and Sikh people were killed. In this area, many Muslim people were killed. And in this area, again, also Muslim people were killed. So in this process, Punjab was divided into two parts, West and East Punjab. And one is part of India, another was part of Pakistan. Then problem arises with Northwest Frontier Province, because one Muslim group supported the joining of Northwest Frontier Province with Pakistan, and another group supported to merge it with India. Mainly includes the areas related with Jammu and Kashmir. So this was the thing happened during that period of time. Now due to the communal riots, many people were living from centuries in their homeland. They shifted from one place to another. And in this process of shifting, they even could not get the support of their local administration. The local people where they lived from centuries, they also did not support them. So in this process of negligency and this process of they became alien in their own states or in their own areas. So in this process, finally people decided that it is better for them to shift their home from one place to another, and that is why the migration process happened. So this was the overall idea about the doubts that you have. Communal riots is nothing but the riots between two groups on the basis of religion. So this was the doubt class. This is the doubt class, and if you have further any issue or problem, you can comment on the comment section, and just read the book thoroughly so that you can understand the various topics. Another thing is that this is your NCERT book, the Politics in India Since Independence. So this book is very good for your exam purpose. Along with your textbook, you can also follow this book, and it will help you in the exam, because there are also pictures given and things are very descriptive, written in a descriptive way. So this is from today's class. Thank you. And in my next class, I will teach you the reorganization of states. Thank you.